is Fatima Whitbread. I'm a former world record holder and world champion javelin thrower. I was abandoned as a baby by my biological mother, and I spent the first 14 years of my life growing up in children's homes. Then my life changed thanks to a foster carer and javelin coach. When I met Mrs. Whitbread through sport, which was my saviour, I realised then I could suddenly start to dream about what my future would hold. That was an amazing transformation, living in a loving, caring family with the Whitbreads. Very lucky. But whilst my foster mother was able to combine a career with fostering, many find it difficult. Here in Newham, a new scheme run by the council and non-profit organisation, Now Foster, hopes to change that by helping people with busy lives and demanding jobs. Care for young people on a part-time basis.
Yeah, absolutely.
Foster parent Laurie Kilby is co-founder of the organisation and says weekend fostering gives children an additional safe adult alongside their long-term foster carers.
What we want to do is lower the barrier to entry so that more people can explore what foster care is and have the joy, the fun, the adventure that I do. And the idea is that you wrap around this child and support them throughout the duration of their life. You grow with the child, you're not learning about 10 different children. You are focused on the experiences of this young person and how you can meet their needs.
And with the national shortage of foster carers estimated at around 10,500, according to the National Fostering Group, this is already encouraging more to sign up, including small business owner Poonam.
How are you?
Who is about to become one of the first foster carers under the new scheme.
Why does part-time foster care work for you? I'm busy, I work full-time, but weekend and part-time foster caring means that you are able to have that commitment, which doesn't impact on your full-time job. When I envision what does part-time foster caring look like, it's let's go to the Lake District, do all of those things maybe a long-term foster carer either doesn't have the capacity for, doesn't have the resources for. That is my aim, to have as much fun as possible.
If it proves to be a success, the hope is that this pilot scheme will be rolled out across the UK. Another way fostering is being encouraged is through businesses. High Street giant John Lewis is one of around 160 companies that are fostering friendly, meaning it gives staff like full-time foster parent Daniel an additional week of paid leave to attend things like training.
So what are the real challenges then, you know, in fostering children and having a full-time job?
I think it is just the time commitments that the fostering brings. Every child will have several meetings that you have to attend that will always be during the working week. I'm not going to lie, it is hard, but it's much more rewarding than it is hard.
Daniel says the paid leave has been a game changer for him and his foster children.
I don't think in the modern world, the cost of living crisis that we're in, people can just foster and not have other forms of income. In the past, to go on a mandatory training course for first aid, I would have taken a day's holiday to do that, whereas now I can take that day off work and use my holiday with the children, which is so much more beneficial.
The outgoing chair of John Lewis, Dame Sharon White, is responsible for its new fostering policy.
We know that if a young person comes into a business, or indeed if the foster carer has more support, not only is it incredibly motivating for your people, but actually it creates real engagement and real loyalty to the business, and before you know it, we've made real impact.
I really hope this pilot scheme in Newham is going to be a great success, because the greatest gift you can give a child is the love and security of a home.
Oh, thank you, Fat.